data from them, what we're working on, how we're starting to use containers. This is a pretty prototype stage report, and then short answer is for testing and just scaling out. So what's our research problem? I work on infrastructure systems, and infrastructure systems provide essential services. Give you a flavor of that. When you turn on a tap to wash your hands with some hot water, the water comes from somewhere, comes through some pipes. Eventually it comes from big reservoir perhaps, like Kilter Water in the north. These are big infrastructure projects that require lots of earth moving and transportation. And you need to get that water to your house eventually. It might require some pumping, which might require some electricity. So you might have a big coal-fired power station, or now converted to biomass, that's tracks. Incidentally, your big power stations need water abstracted from the rivers to provide cooling. Or you might have some renewable wind, which needs solar power, which depends on the variability of light and weather, and that's kind of keeps changing. So you need to get that electricity back through the transmission and distribution systems to the house to then wash your hands. This kind of socio-technical system, people running these systems and making decisions about how to plan into the future. First problem, we've got two problems to note. Projections are really uncertain, while decisions about these kind of things have really long-term effects. So here's the ONS is population projection from based on 2014 data through to about 2039. And that's from about 65 million people in the UK to anywhere between about 70 and about 80. That's 10 million people difference that we're looking to serve with these basic pieces of kit. To give you an old example of a piece of infrastructure, that's Joseph Basil Shep in the kind of top hat, building London's sewer system in the 19th century. He built it when London was about 1.5 million people, 3 million tops. And it's now 6-7 million people, and that oversupply has served us well through the 20th century. We now need to build even more big pipes. So we've got a large decision problem to try and understand. Second problem to work with is that expertise really sits in sector silos. So we have people who really know a lot about water, about wastewater, separate from that maybe, about the energy system, about the transport system, about communications. But our hypothesis within this TRC Mistral research program that we've attached to is that interactions between sectors comply with really important risks and opportunities. So as we look for efficiencies in the system, making those interactions between sector water and energy even more efficient, or using the minimum resources to provide those essential services, mainly make our systems more vulnerable to whatever risks we're exposed to, whether that's climate change, flood risks, or any others. Okay, so how are we starting to use containers? Where does the software come into this? Corresponding to each of those infrastructure sectors, we've got engineering simulation models and social science, demand side models, looking at what people are likely to need in the future and how those systems might operate. So we've got individual models developed separately for each of the systems that we then want to connect together and explore the interactions and assess these possible decisions over the long term, under population scenarios, under economic scenarios, under climate change scenarios, and sort of see how we might try and make decisions over those systems. So, number one, this is bread and butter, but it's worth mentioning. All these various models have various software dependencies. You can patch the model, continuous integration tools, write our little Travis configuration, get some nice patches. That's worth mentioning. Then, scaling out. At the moment, we're thinking about running a container with a second model for a single time step, whether on top of one, with a single scenario and a single set of decisions. So, we really need to have this kind of simulation of the operation of, say, the water sector for a single year that we run once, and then we have many of those kind of jobs that we stitch together to make a simulation of multiple years to examine the decision process. And the state we're in at the moment is this kind of process that we've seen with a piping client that talks to the Docker a bit ad hoc, but it's our first stab at stitching together containers and passing data between talking to a shared data store. So there are cool opportunities for really high-level parallelism in that we've got these independent scenarios and we've got fairly independent decision-making processes we want to explore. But there's perhaps obviously a path dependence through time, so if we make a decision to build something, it can still be available in time steps going forward. And then there's the interesting bit, which is the possibly complex dependencies between sector models. So that's where energy demands water, but water demands energy, and each of them being transport, and transport is talking to digital communications because we've got autonomous electric vehicles, which means sometimes storage. So hypothesize that there are lots of interactions to play around with there. So this is something we've sort of started to work out in notionally each of our sector models is in the node there on the dot. And with that graph of dependencies, we can get the strongly connected components to find this conversation. The graph that gives us something that is directed and asymmetric. And inside each of those yellow circles, we can do that iteration of these things to solve those more complicated interdependencies. So the conceptual side of that. The hardware side is that there's this data analytics facility for national infrastructure that we're an early tester of, which is going to be launched on 6th of July. It's a year of design planning work. So if anyone's interested in this sector, then grab me to talk about thinking through requirements for this. It's not directly related to our project, but we're going to test it for it. And then this group of people today talking about hearing people having problems thinking through workflow and thinking through distribution of containers. These are open questions I have to look for again. So the benefits and trade-offs of Docker swarming services, so this notion that Docker is really configured for its microservice networked microservice architecture, and how we should move on rather than try moving another job or task scheduler to handle this kind of this dynamic graph of tasks that we need to run and sort of reevaluate as we go through our systems model and process. Quick summary, we're trying to plan infrastructure for essential services, so these connect some sector simulation models,